A lot of times people see a sort of disconnect between humanistic experiences and biology and then like engineering and technology and, you know, big data. But I think something that has really driven me from early on is this sense that both of those domains can learn from each other and kind of coexist in a very harmonious way. My name is Sheun Aluko. I go by Shay. I'm a fourth year medical student right now, but just applied into the bioinformatics master's program, and I'm hoping to graduate with both the MD and the master's. I grew up in Memphis, Tennessee, but I was born in Singapore. When I play music and I really get into that space, I feel like I just am able to have such joy. And I think that music also is a way to communicate that sort of transcends many other forms of communication. The first time I became interested in medicine probably goes back to a book that I read in high school early on called The Body Electric. And it was about allowing patients who, you know, had lost movement of a limb to actually regain some sort of independence by implanting electrodes in their brain and then having those electrodes control like a robotic arm, for example. And that really caught my imagination, I think, and got me interested in biomedical engineering. While at Stanford, I had the opportunity to work on a project that involves creating a device for children with cerebral palsy to learn to walk better. So it's a feedback device that kind of analyzes their walking in real time and then provides an auditory feedback tone. And that will allow them to learn to walk in a way that doesn't predispose them to tripping over their feet. One of the unique things about Stanford is the ability to come here and get a top-notch medical education, but also being able to develop a unique skill set that, you know, you might want to develop. And Stanford really encourages that and really gives you the tools that you need to succeed in that. Stanford is really generous in the financial aid that they offer. Being able to know that I'm going to finish medical school without a huge amount of debt definitely impacts the way I'm thinking about which specialty I want to choose. You know, I can write a program and then deploy that program across the whole world, across servers, can do billions and trillions of transactions a second while I'm sleeping. That could be processing patient data, could be doing research in the background. At the end of the day, like, those things are gonna bring value back to patients as well.